let's enter into today's satsang in Bhagavad Gita, fourth chapter, Jnanakarma Sannyasa Yoga, 37th verse.
Yatai dhamsi samiddha agnir bhasmasat kuruter juna jnanagni sarva karmani bhasmasat kurute tata.
Yatai te dhamsi samiddha agnihi bhasmasat kuruter juna Jnanagni sarvakarmani vasmasat kurute tata. As the fire that is kindled burns into ashes the fuel, O Arjuna, in the same manner the fire of experience burns into ashes all the actions, the patterns that keep making the person repeat the same action. God. These are all straight attack. Understand, Bhagavan is not talking to you in a roundabout way. Simple truths, very straight. Say straight away, just like fire burns the fuel, the experience burns all the patterns. Over. I don't know what to comment on this. Such a simple truth being expressed in such small number of words. Please understand, such beautiful truth expressed in such a small number of words. Just as a blazing fire turns firewood into ashes, blazing fire turns fuel into ashes, the experience turns all the patterns into ashes. So strive in all possible ways to achieve experience. Let me define experience. What is experience? Experience is something flows into your system like a current or a vibration, makes your mind stop working in the same patterns in which it is functioning. Sometime it can be very light current flow, sometime it can be a wild explosion, but the vibrations which moves into your system and makes you understand the strong truth about yourself. See, that is the reason the Kundalini awakening and levitation liberates you so quickly, because every time I awaken your Kundalini, you are programmed to my inner space, patternless space. Every time your body jumps, some part of your patterns are destroyed. Every time your body moves, some part of your patterns are taken away. You can see every time when your body levitates, tell yourself, this time I'll be free from this pattern. I tell you, every time it is renovating your system, that's exactly right word, renovating your system. Every time the system in which you are living is renovated and rejuvenated, because experience breaks any number of patterns. You may be thinking, no, 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 not mine. You don't know the amount of patterns I have. But whether it is 1 ton firewood or 1,000,000 ton firewood, kindled fire is capable of putting off, burning any amount of firewood into ashes. So the kindled experience, the awakened kundalini, is capable of burning any amount of karmas, patterns into ashes. Work, work, work with all the intensity to experience the ultimate, to experience the ultimate. Kindled experience can lead you to any level, any amount, any path. Kindled experience can show you the truth. Kindled experience can lead you to reality. Awakened kundalini can program your inner space pattern free. So work again and again and again and again for experience. Every day I am receiving more and more emails that people are practicing prana samyama. I am very happy about it, because wasting the time without working for experience is the crime. That is the reason every day I remind you to work for experience. Every day I insist you put your awareness and energy towards experience. The methods directly leading to experience. Unclutching, feeling connection, ajapa ajapa, enchanting, feeling connection, unclutching. Constantly I remind you, it is for experience this whole Dhyanapidam is created. For experience all these temples are created. For experience I am sitting alive. For experience, to give experience, I am bearing with all this nonsensical, foolish enmity. Yesterday again one bull, sorry, bull is sacred for Hindus, one donkey, of course, even donkey is sacred for Hindus, what to do, everything is sacred for us. All right, one dash dash is telling me, still he keeps Venkateshwara in all his temples. It is indiscipline. He should not be in Madurai Adinam throne. This fool doesn't know, still I have Mahavir in my temples. And I have spoken on Jain Sutras. Jnana Sambandhar conquered Jain monks. The Nityananda Jnana Sambandha has spoken on Jain Sutras. Understand, both are one and the same. He has conquered illusory, experienceless Jain monks into experiencing seekers. I did not conquer. I just tried to bring experience to Jain monks directly. That's all. Understand? Both is same. He did not fight with Mahavira. He did not fight with Tirthankaras, no. The fellows who diluted Tirthankaras, the enemies of Tirthankaras, enemies of Mahavira only, Jnana Sambandha fought. Again, just like how Jnana Sambandha has to fight with people who are sitting in Jainism but enemies of Mahavira, I have to fight with people who are sitting in Shaiva Siddhanta who are enemies of Jnana Sambandha and Upper and Trinavakarasa, Sundara and Shiva. when you don't have experience, religion becomes load. Religious centers become criminal planning centers. Religious heads become plot strategy planners. If you don't have experience, not only everything is waste, everything is dangerous. See the Vedic tradition. When Buddha comes, all the Vedic pandits are conquered and they become Buddhists. When Shankara comes, all Buddhists are conquered and they become again belong to Vedic tradition. When Nagarjuna comes, again all the Vedic pandits are conquered and they become Buddhists. What is going on? When Jnanasambandar comes, again all the Buddhists and Jain monks are conquered and they become Saivites. What is going on? What is truth? Understand, in Vedic tradition, the land of Vedic tradition in India, only one is respected. Only one thing, the experience. If somebody can give me the deeper experience than in which I am staying, I am just ready to follow him. I don't care about anything else. That is the only religion of Vedic tradition. That is why still we are alive even after so much of invasion, attack, persecution and false prosecutions. The experienceless Jews, Romans who crucified Jesus, experienceless. Jainas who were trying to kill Jnanasambandar, those same fellows are also only back. Experienceless Shaivites trying to abuse me. When you do not experience, when you don't have experience, not only everything is waste, everything is dangerous. The wealth they have in their hand, the infrastructure they have in their hand, everything is dangerous. The wealth, the social power. Organization strength. Everything is just for one thing, only one reason: giving experience, spiritual experience to people. I tell you, we will be alive, growing, expanding as long as we give spiritual experience to people. All our temples, centers, devotees, organizers, remember this one thing: as long as you conduct spiritual classes, programs, inspire people, share spiritual experience with them, you will be alive. Continuously put your energy in that direction. Even giving our book and telling them to read is sharing spiritual experience. Medical camps, annadan, all this will not keep the Sangha alive. All these are only social services. It is like doing little good, sharing what you have. But the Sangha, the spiritual community will be kept alive only by having more and more spiritual experience and sharing more and more spiritual experience with others, giving more and more spiritual experience to others. See, in the young age, once I had the darshan of Kamakshi. I was walking in Thiruvannamalai. suddenly in front of me I saw one divine form whose feet is not touching the ground. I rushed and tried to put my hand between her feet and the ground. I could see very clearly she was not on the ground, she was just above the ground. Then I realized she is Kamakshi. And she just started walking. I simply followed. I don't know how many hours it took, but without any non-stop, I reached Kanchipuram. When I came to awareness, I was there in Kanchipuram. I want to tell you this incident because it is very important. Earlier, just 2 days before, I had a discussion with Vibhudanandamuri, Mataji, Kuppammal. There was a casual conversation. She asked me, if God appears in front of you and asks, what do you want, what will you ask? I said, naturally, Atma Sakshatkara. That is the word I know at that time for enlightenment. Atma Sakshatkara, because that was the traditional Tamil word for enlightenment. She said, no, you should not ask for that. I was shocked and asked, what do you mean? Then what should I ask? She said, ask, you should never settle down. Become contented till you achieve the ultimate. I could not understand. Both mean same, na? She said, no. Whatever you understand as Atma Sakshatkara is not Atma Sakshatkara. So do not use any word and limit. If you ask for Atma Sakshatkara, at that time what you remember, what you understand, Devi will say Tathastu. You will have only that and you are stuck with that. As I should not rest until the ultimate, the what needs to be done is done. Please understand, I asked her exactly that same thing. I remembered that Kuppammal's statement. I asked her exactly the same thing. And something happened in my left side of the heart, like a black patch. I started feeling an experience, means like a unfulfillment, kind of a discontentment, settling in my right heart. The patch of unfulfillment, like a mole on the skin, I felt, and it was there for quite number of years, and slowly it started moving in my skin after many years, and around maybe 17 or 18, it went down to my navel center and became white patch. And still that white patch is there. When it became white patch, that discontentment has disappeared from me. After that only, I never had any discontentment. Maybe I can take it in the other sense. What needs to be achieved is achieved in this body. I tell you, if we trace some of my young age pictures, we will be able to trace that small black patch which later on disappeared. I can still remember very clearly, as not to get content till the ultimate experience happens. Please meditate on this one thing. Today all of you, pray for this one thing from the ultimate. Let me not be content. Let me not feel settled till I achieve the ultimate. Till the ultimate starts happening in you. Because the discontentment is powerful enough to guide you towards that ultimate. Understand, if you feel discontent in money, that discontentment alone is enough, capable to teach you all the methods, to make you find all the methods to achieve money and make you achieve it. Deep discontentment inside your being is capable of showing you the path and making you achieve the ultimate. Do not settle down for anything you think as ultimate. Ask always what divine thinks as ultimate, let that happen. Unfortunately, so many times you settle down for what you think as ultimate. No. Today, sit with a deep feeling connection, prayerful mood, request the divine, surrender to the divine, asking, let me not settle down, let me not feel contented, fulfilled, till what you think as ultimate is showered on me, not what I think as ultimate, what you think as ultimate. Till that happens in this body, let me not settle down, let me not be content.
Lama, Nelson Mandela, Oprah Winfrey, Paulo Coelho and others by Mind, Body, Spirit, the world's top esoteric magazine from Watkins, London's oldest and largest bookstore. A yogi by birth, he has been expressing his power of enlightenment since birth. He has authored more than 500 books in Tamil and English. Translations of these books are available in 26 languages, in Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam, Hindi, Sanskrit, Gujarati, Oriya, Bengali, Marathi, French, Malay, Polish, Portuguese, Italian, German, Danish, Spanish, Russian and Chinese. He is also an exemplary speaker with over 10,000 hours of profound life solutions through his discourses. Social services such as Annadan, free medical care, free educational services with ashrams, schools, temples, hospitals established in more than 140 places around the world, offering exceptional services. A powerful spiritual healer who has healed millions of people of diseases from migraine to cancer. A Kriya Yogi who has formulated Kriyas for physical health and mental well-being, benefiting thousands. A living master who offers practical solutions for our everyday problems. He is the founder and spiritual head of Nityananda Dhyanapitam, a spiritual powerhouse who has revived the sacred Vedic tradition by establishing Vedic temples in places like Los Angeles, San Jose, Seattle, Toronto, Ohio, Oklahoma, Phoenix, St. Louis, Malaysia, Brazil, Paris, Guadeloupe, Dallas, New York, New Jersey, Atlanta, Calgary, Vancouver, Singapore, and places in India like Bengaluru, Hyderabad, Tiruvannamalai. A spiritual guru for 10 million followers, an incarnation who transmits the highest spiritual energy through initiation, a contemporary yogi who has revived the Vedic science of yoga worldwide through thousands of yoga centers, an adept in Ashtamahasiddhis, mystical yogic powers, who has effortlessly awakened the kundalini of thousands and graced them with spiritual powers, a dynamic young guru who is an inspiration for thousands of youngsters, India's most watched spiritual guru online, a beacon of spiritual light who has triumphed over the forces of religious terrorism and political persecution. Paramahamsa Nityananda is an eternal Kalpataru, blessing the world with the boons of material abundance and spiritual enlightenment.
Vande papa vinashaktam Nityanandaya swagatam Nityamuktam nirvikalpam ज्ञानलोक प्रदीपकम् वंदे शांतमयम् बंधम् नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम् आनंद गंध संचारम् सर्वोपाधि विनिर्मुक्तम् वंदे ज्ञानालयम् नाथम् नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम्
Let you all achieve, experience, live, express, radiate, share and explore in eternal bliss. Nityananda.
Nityananda Dhyana Peetham, Nityananda Nagar, off Mysore Road, Bidadi, Bangalore, 562109. Contact 0974220331. www.nityananda.org. www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation.